Today's show is brought to you by Fandor. Sign up online or in the app for a free one-week trial. Just $4.99 a month for your all-access pass. Playing now on Fandor is 13 Nights of Elvira. In this series, Elvira, Mistress of the Dark, takes on some of the best of the worst modern B-movies like Puppet Master and Cannibal Woman in the Avocado Jungle of Death, and gives her point of view.
Hey everyone, welcome to another Fandor video podcast. Hello, Chris Kelly. Can you tell us where you are?
Hey, Human. I'm in Jackson Hole, Wyoming at the Mullis Media Conference. Nice. Absolutely wanted to take part in the podcast in this wonderful interview.
Well, you're going to introduce her in a second here, Chris, but welcome, Bryn.
Thank
you. Love having
you
as well.
Always happy to be here.
Chris, go ahead and introduce our guest.
So Claudia Puig from the Santa Barbara Film Festival is joining us, and we could not be more excited.
I'm very excited, too. Thank you.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you for being here, Claudia. Claudia, how long have you been a part of the Santa Barbara Film Festival, and what do you do there?
First, I just want to say I want to be in Jackson Hole right now. But anyway.
We all do.
Yes, I did come down off the mountain skiing to do this. So.
Wow. Okay. Well, I'm honored. I have not been with the festival for very long, actually. I joined in September of 2021. And I've been spent most of my life as a film critic on NPR and at USA Today. And before that, I was a film writer at the LA Times. But in the last 5 years since I left USA Today, I've been programming film festivals. I did one, the Napa Valley Film Festival and the Mendocino Film Festival and a film festival in Chapel Hill, North Carolina, and also AFI here in Los Angeles, here being that I'm in LA, not Jackson Hole.
Are you the big boss? Are you the one that says yes or no to the films that submit?
Well, yes, but there are a few others. We have a programming team, and so that's four people. And then there is the big boss, who's the festival director. That's Roger Durling. And we have a managing director. That's Sean Pratt. So, but they're kind of involved in the bigger picture. So when it comes to the actual films, it's myself and the programming team.
When is the festival this year?
March 2nd through 12th. So it's coming right up in person.
In person. Is it entirely in person or is it hybrid?
Entirely in person. No
hybrid. So if you're not there, you don't get to see the movies.
That's right. Sadly. Yes. But we're really excited because we have, I think there's a real thirst, obviously, for people to get together and, you know, that sense of community that you get at film festivals. So we have people coming from all over the world. It's shocking to me that we have as many people who are, you know, especially given that we're still kind of in a pandemic, but people are really hungry to be there with their films, to see other people's films. So we have people coming from as far as Nepal, from all over the world. Yeah.
Can you give us well, it's interesting you said that because we just interviewed the woman who about the first female Sherpa.
Yes, and that's going to be a world premiere with us. We're super excited about that film.
We might actually come down for that. It's on the 5th of March.
We're talking about it with Allison. So yeah.
Oh, excellent. Well, please do come down for that. That'll be, and we also have another sort of outdoorsy film coming from Cuba. It's called Havana Libre, and it's about surfers in Cuba where it's forbidden to surf. And so for both of those, I had to send special letters to the government to ask, you know, to them to release people to come for the festival. You know, everybody has a different, you know, sort of governmental policy. But those are two really great ones.
What other films are you excited about this year?
Oh, got a lot. There's a film called Our Words Collide that I just love. It's about young high school students who are, you know, come from sort of disadvantaged backgrounds in Los Angeles who have discovered poetry, and poetry has helped them deal with all kinds of issues in their, you know, in their lives. And they're going to come and they're going to recite some poetry. So that's going to be fantastic. Rosario Dawson is the executive producer of that. We have another film called Belle Vie, which is about a restaurant that is kind of tracing what the restaurant went through during COVID, sort of the ups and downs and opening and closing and outdoors and, you know, indoors and all that. That's going to be interesting. We have another one that's about theaters, specifically about a independent theater chain, also what they went through. So we have quite a few that are COVID related. And then we have a lot of international films from 54 different countries around the world. Mm-hmm. And we have a Latin American section with some fantastic films, Spanish and Latin American. This year we've added a Middle Eastern and Israeli section because we have some wonderful films from...
You have any movies from Iran?
We do. We have two films from Iran. Yeah. One of them is about an Iranian swimmer, a woman who was not allowed to swim. And the name of the film is Orca. And so she swam in a full burqa, a full suit in the ocean. And she broke some records in the Guinness Book of World Records.
Wow.
It's really great. It's a narrative version. So it's not a documentary, but it's fantastic.
Is there, is it really clear online on your website what day and time every movie is showing?
It will be. It will be this week. We announce our official lineup. So we're doing this a little bit in advance. We announce it on Thursday. So after Thursday, yes, all our films, the countries they come from, whether they're premieres, whether they're subtitled, all of that information will be online on SBIFF.org, Santa Barbara International Film Festival. We also have all kinds of tributes to like Oscar nominees this year.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you. Any celebrities in attendance this
year? Oh my
year?
Gosh, so many celebrities.
Let us know what celebrities. This is what everybody wants.
Yes, right. So we have a special tribute to Kristen Stewart, who is nominated for Best Actress. We have a tribute to Benedict Cumberbatch, nominated for Best Actor. We have tributes to Penelope Cruz and Javier Bardem, who are both nominated for Best Actor and Actress, respectively. We have we will have tributes to all the directors that were nominated today. We have Will Smith and Anjaneu Ellis, who are both
Chris
nominated.
Is with Will Smith right now, by the way.
With Will Smith momentarily tonight. So.
Oh, excellent. Yep. In Jackson Hole, he's there?
In Jackson Hole, yeah.
Oh, my goodness. So, yeah, we'll have him here, too.
Small world, huh?
So, yeah, it's going to be all kinds of stars. It's going to be very star-studded. And then we have, like, individual films. For instance, there's a really wonderful documentary called The 90s Club. It's about people in their 90s who are amazing, who are sharp as tacks. One of them is Dick Van Dyke. So he's featured. He'll be at the festival. Uh-huh. It's going to be a really – oh, and then we also have a Virtuoso Award. So we present awards to Ariana DeBose, who was nominated today for Best Supporting Actress for West Side Story. Alana Haint from Licorice Pizza will be showing Licorice Pizza like for a free screening. Amelia Jones from CODA. Troy Kotsur, who was nominated for Supporting Actor today. Sanaa Sidney from King Richard. So there's going to be lots of stars over the course of our 10 days.
So let's end with this. What initiatives is the film festival highlighting that we should be aware of?
We have all kinds of health. We have lots of educational initiatives, not health related, but we do have health protocols in place.
Of course.
So we have, we have screenwriting and filmmaking mentorship competition. We have a lot of programs for kids coming to the movies. It's called Mike's Field Trip to the Movies. We have a film studies program where we invite 30 undergraduate film students from across the country in places that are not like LA and New York, where they wouldn't have access to filmmakers. They'll be there. We have seminars available, you know, for everyone to attend. We have a special award from the Anti-Defamation League for a dramatic film. So we have all kinds of educational programs, and most of them are free. So they're really a wonderful way to give back to the community.
Nice. Her name, Chris, what's her name?
Fantastic. Claudia Puig.
Claudia Puig. Her name's Claudia Puig. She is the program director for the Senate Park.
What the heck?
What'd you say?
I'll go by Renee. It's a perfectly nice name.
Let's call her Renee. It's the Santa Barbara Film Festival. It's happening March 2nd to the 12th, correct?
That is correct. March 2nd through 12th. Opening night is March 2nd, and we finish, that's on a Wednesday, and we finish up on Saturday, March 12th. Great movies. We have about 200 movies, lots of stars, and all kinds of great activities. So come.
We wish you nothing but the best, Claudia. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much, Human and Chris and Brian. Nice to see you.
Thanks, Claudia. Good to meet you.
Have a good one.
Thanks for tuning in. Today's show is brought to you by Fandor. Sign up online or in the app for a free one-week trial. Playing now on Fandor is 13 Nights of Elvira. In this series, Elvira, Mistress of the Dark, takes on some of the best of the worst modern B-movies like Puppet Master and Cannibal Woman in the Avocado Jungle of Death, and gives her point of view and ultimately her verdict. That's F-A-N-D-O-R, the home for cinephiles.